fact that he humiliated me before those low lives simply because I was doing what was right.
What right thing? What were you doing? Huh? What's the right thing you're talking about? Going to sack palace maidens? Did you hire them? What is wrong with you? How can you be sacking people you didn't hire? What am I supposed to explain everything to you? It's wrong, for God's sake.
Hold on, I want to understand something. Osinachi, you mean you sacked the palace cook as the maidens?
Yes, father, I did because they stole my jewelries. I left only Uzamaka because she's the one that is very loyal and faithful amongst all those evil girls. Those girls are criminals.
But you don't have the right to sack them, sack my workers, without my consent. I hope they didn't leave.
No, father. They're still somewhere in the palace. They're around. But we just need to teach her that it's wrong. Let her think before she acts.
All the same, Kanayo. You shouldn't have disrespected her before the commoners.
Thank you, mother.
Eh? You shouldn't have talked the way you talked to her according to what she said. It's not fair. I don't support that.
Mother, I did not disrespect her, all right? I didn't talk to her in a bad way. Teach my younger sister how to do things. Stop spoiling her. Teach her that it's wrong. You cannot fire people you did not hire. It's not done anywhere. There's hierarchy when it comes to royalty. You notice anything, talk to me, then I'm going to present it to father. You can still go straight and present it to father. That is how it's done. But you don't fire people like that. You didn't hire them. Teach her the right thing. Father, please, I'm sorry I'm raising my voice. I beg you, let this whole thing slide, please.
Let what slide? Okay, I understand.
Father, are you going to let it go just like that? Father, to be frank with you, I don't like your method in this palace. So the way you people treat me like nobody, like I don't have my own rights again. This is not fair. This is not fair. It's not fair.
You're being unfair to her.
She is your daughter, your princess. I mean it never fool. We are one.
I mean never fool. Let's stop the segregation. Let's stop the discrimination. And let the love of India.
No more fighting. No more killing. I called the hospital and was told you've moved her out from there.
Why would you call the hospital? What's your business there?
I, Queen Ugeboibo, have no business in visiting the hospital that is situated in my kingdom?
Mm-hmm.
Are you serious?
Of course I'm serious. I spoke with Dr. Caleb. He told me everything. Why have you chosen the path of wickedness? Why? Huh? Path of evil?
She's a threat and has to be taken out.
Mother, what has that girl done to you? Tell me. Tell me just one thing. What did she do to you? One.
Like I said, son, she is a threat. And everything about her is cursed.
You're not making sense to me, Mother.
You are going too close to her for my liking. And I have to stop you before you go further deep with her. Even if it means taking her life.
Tell me, son, I want you to be very frank and honest with me. Do you have anything going on between you and the girl as an emotional attachment?
No, father.
Just tell me the truth. You know I'll always speak. I'll believe you.
Of course, I have no reason to lie to you. I've told you the truth. I don't have anything, any kind of emotional attachment with the girl. None. For me, Father, I love everybody equally. You know, I want everybody in this kingdom to be happy. You know, that's why, you know, I want equal rights. Whether you are Osu or not Osu, I don't care. I want people to be treated with respect. You know, I don't believe in, you know, treating people the wrong way. That's not me.
You know, that's what the tradition demands.
Father, away from that, please. I'm here to seek your permission to move that girl out of this palace. Please, I don't want her to stay here anymore.
Why did you say this?
Father, her life is in danger. That's the much I can say for now.
You know the girl in question gave a promise on the number of years she's going to stay in this palace.
I heard that. It won't be a problem. Convert those years to money. I'll pay. She'll have her freedom.
It's not a matter of pay. You know you are a crown prince. And whatever you demand, you'll get, unless you get a replacement for her.
Thank you, Father. Thank you. I really appreciate this. I will get her a replacement. It won't be a problem, man. I thank you for always being the noble man that I know as my father and the king of our kingdom. Thank you, Father.
Now let me ask you this question again. Do you have anything going between you and that girl? I mean, like I said before, as an emotional attachment.
I don't, Father. If there was something going on, I'll let you know. You know I've never lied to you. I'll always tell you, nothing.
Let's stop the segregation, let's stop the discrimination, and let's love all India. No more fighting, no more killing.
And what happened? What? Get out!
Wait.
Get out now, Uzamaka!
Get out? How? Eh? You are asking me out of the room that also belongs to me.
Uzamaka,
I don't understand. Are you being serious?
Uzamaka. Uzamaka, you want to see madness. You want to see what we can do. Eh? I don't understand. What are we even talking about? Eh? That you were caught with stolen items. How does it concern
you? Oh, will you shut up? So you think we don't know it was you that set us up? You think we don't know?
Ajonwa. Uzamaka. You had the guts to tamper with my bag in my absence, Uzamaka. All because we were trying to expose you. You were busy plotting your evil. Uzamaka, you!
See, the king will have a look at the picture by the end of this month. Since that same time, the queen asked us to live here. But for now, get out of this room. Get out.
I am not going anywhere. This room belongs to me. Get out.
Get out. Are you sure the princess will not come to her aid? I'm scared.
Gene. Which princess? Eh? We can only obey the king. The queen and the prince, henceforth in this palace, yes.
Let her go be with the princess for like
here.
Nonsense. I am going to report you to the princess.
Get out, you can go report for all I care. I don't have time for the princess. I can only obey the king, the queen, and the prince.
My princess, I'm so sorry.
No, you don't have to say that, okay? Listen, I was planning to come to yours to apologize properly tomorrow for my behavior. You know, there was no reason for me to be that rude, especially the way I asked you out of my car. I'm really sorry and ashamed of that behavior. Okay? I really do not know what came over me. Please find it in your heart to forgive me, okay?
No. You don't have to apologize. Please. I take all the blames. Yes. Because had it been I did all you wanted me to do, things wouldn't have turned out this way. Please. Find a place in your heart to forgive me. I'm so sorry, please.
Oh my God, you're so sweet. Thank you. Thank you for being sweet, you know. You are the 15th man I've been with. And you are so different. What I love about you is the ability to always, you know, adjust and learn. unlike the rest men I've been with. Those ones be acting like they are doing me a favor by being in a relationship with me. Like I care. Simple instruction they would not want to, you know, to take. It's difficult dealing with some people. I'm very glad you came into my life.
My princess.
I love you.
And I love you more. I promise you, henceforth, I will do anything you want me to do. Anything. It's a promise.
Uh-oh.
Yes.
Come here.
Come here. I love you.
I love you too.
But you didn't care to ask me if I've brushed my mouth today.
That is because I'm beginning to trust you. And I know you wouldn't want to do anything to disobey my orders.
Of course I will not. You're the best.
Thank you. Listen, I've got this special place I want to take you to.
Really?
I'll be right back.
Really?
My stuff.
Okay.
I'll surprise you.
Love you.
My princess, it's the other maidens. They chased me out of the room.
Chased you out? Why?
I don't know. They're just being wicked, unnecessary to me. I don't know, my princess.
You didn't do anything to them and they just chased you out like that? No, I doubt so.
My princess, I didn't...
Listen to me. You go sort yourself out with them, okay? I've got a date, as you can see.
My princess, please. At least you can talk to these people. They pushed me out of the room.
Wait a minute. You actually want me to abandon my important appointment and go speak to those lowlifes because of you? Because you are who? No, because you are who? Who are you? Watch it. Just watch it.
Upon all I have been doing for those idiots, she doesn't take any of my requests serious. But I will show her Pepe.
This life is full of us. No one is too little to be ignored. And you need never fool. So bring back the equality. Abolish the slavery and segregation. You need never fool. We are one.
You look great, my king.
Oh, mother.
Greetings.
You look like you've seen a ghost.
No. This is abomination. What are you doing beside my son? What?
She's my wife. This is her place beside me.
This cursed thing? She can't be your wife.
Mother.
Leave my son alone.
Mother! Do not call her a cursed thing again. Don't.
She is cursed. Where did you get that thing from? Leave my son
alone. Mother! One more word from you, I'll strip you of everything that makes you royalty. One more word. The king has spoken.
Wait. They were here. My son was standing here, and the cursed girl by his side, holding him so tight. I am sure of what I'm saying now. This is where they were. They were here. How come? My son was the king, while the cursed girl was the queen. Oh my God. So it was a dream. I know my dream. I know how it happens.
My queen, the food is ready. Should I set the dining now?
Will you get out of my sight? Out!
Doesn't answer my question. What's going on? Why have you come into my room dressed this way?
Oh, my prince, my original intention was to clean your room for you since that slave girl is not around.
Let this be the last time you call her a slave girl. Is that clear? Is that clear?
I'm sorry.
Look at you. See how horrible you look in this nonsense you're putting on. Leave my room.
My prince, please, can I at least get my cleaning items to clean your room
I
for
said
you?
Get out of my room. Get out!
I'm sorry. I'm sorry, my prince.
You made me a promise that you can talk to him, right?
Yes, my queen. Honestly, I did.
My queen, I thought I would have reasoned with that stupid boy. That fool. But he disappointed me.
And what gave you the audacity to call someone names right in my presence?
Apologies, my queen. I am sorry.
Now go on your knees. You will remain here till tomorrow morning. Not just for disappointing me, but for calling someone names right in my presence. Fool.
Was a babe, I will engage her today because she did her job diligently today. Ojigeji, come Ojigeji. Ojigeji, fool. I thought you said the queen was your bestie. You said she's your buddy. Look at what your buddy did to you. Then you also need her here. You will remain here till tomorrow. You see the order?
This boy, you better mind your position in this palace. Else, one day, for your head.
I like the way you are minding your own position. With your bended knees, I like it. See the way you are minding your own position. Very sharp. All the okay. All the, come on, get away, you. Idiot. Oh, yeah. Try to. Your Highness. My queen. Do nonsense now. Let her come and you slap and tear your face here. Yeah. Animal. You just employ the ordinary guard. You form more than the king. You are carrying yourself more than the Igwe self. And no here.
You think karma is not seeing you? This is just the beginning. Igwe Kwete, and no here. Fool.
Get out! Get out! Get out!
Guess who we have here? Melody! Ta-la-la!
Look at you!
Oh,
Melody! Wow! Good to see you!
Good to see you too! Oh my god! Oh my god! You've added so much weight!
I know, right?
And you even added some hairs! Compared to the last time we saw your first time!
Yeah, good to see you!
Good to see you!
And you've grown into a very beautiful woman.
Really?
Good to see you.
Okay, guys, I'll excuse you for a sec. I've got something on fire. Mm.
Do you cook? Have you ever cooked since I got to know you?
Wait a minute. Are you trying to embarrass me before my friend? You saying I can't cook for myself?
I never said that. I just said you don't cook. And we have maids in the palace, so you don't cook. You rather buy food than cook.
Okay, no problem. You win. Because of what you said, I'm going to surprise. I will let you eat my meal so you can judge.
All right.
All right?
Till then.
Melody?
Till then.
All right, baby. Oh, my God. Oh, good to see you.
Good to see you, too. Sit down.
You've never changed, you know? The way you play around with your sister.
Yeah.
You know, you joke around. That's so cool.
Well, I think I changed a little bit. But not so much that you can no longer recognize me.
You can see that again.
So, how are you?
I'm beautiful. And how have you been?
We're trying.
Oh, it's so good to see
you.
Good
to see you again.
Oh, wow. You guys have a nice place here.
Thank you. Melody.
Yes, baby.
Good to see you again.
Yeah, good to see you. So give me one reason. You just forgot everything about me. The moment I left for London.
I'm really very sorry about that. I've been so busy. Yes, so busy. I've been doing a lot of humanitarian work.
Wow.
Yeah, these days I don't focus on myself that much. I focus on other people.
Mm-hmm. That's so good.
I live for others now.
Oh, you know, that's one thing I love so much about you. You care for people more than you care for yourself. And that's so good. Living for people is very good. Not being selfish. You know, that's why I love you so much. You know what? I'm back for you. Yeah.
I see. Don't worry, my mother will soon be here. I know she would love to see you.
Yeah.
Aha.
Hey. Who do we have here?
Oh my goodness.
Melody, my dear. How are you?
I'm fine.
You're looking so good.
Oh, thank you.
Please sit.
You look so beautiful.
Thank you, my dear. Wow, how about your parents?
They're good.
Especially your father.
You know, he sent his regards to you and the king.
Has he ever mentioned it to you that he and the king were classmates?
Oh, really?
Yeah.
No.
There is a reason.
And what's the reason, mother?
The king told me they used to compete in everything in school. From football to athletics. From athletics to who become first in class. But you know, in everything, the king will always defeat him.
Oh, I see. Thank you so much for having me around.
You're welcome.
I should be on my way now.
All right. Thank you for coming around. Thank you. Thank you so much. I appreciate it. And, well, like I said before, you've remained so beautiful. In fact, you've added to that beauty by getting a master's degree from a prestigious university in the UK. Nice.
Thank you so much. You know, that achievement was a milestone achievement, you know. So it took a lot, and I'm so grateful to God and to my parents who sent me there to study.
I'm happy for you.
Thank you, my friend. Thank you.
All right then. All right then. I'll see you some other time.
Okay, so you will come to my place to get me tomorrow, right?
I can't really guarantee that because I'm always very busy. Yeah, but I'll try.
Busy for me? Okay, you know what? You know, I told you, baby, I am back. I'm back for us to start afresh. I really missed you.
Let me see you.
Right? Okay. All right.
This life is full of us. No one is too little to be ignored. And you need never fool. So bring back the quality. Abolish this slavery as it
be. Melody.
Yes, my queen.
I thought you came with your things already.
No. I feel that's awkward. And the prince hasn't even asked me to move in. So I wouldn't want to be too forward.
Are you waiting for him to open his mouth to say that?
Yes.
He's never going to say that. Because he's the shy type.
Yes, Melody, my mother is right. You see, my brother, he's quite shy and not really into women.
Exactly.
Yeah. So, as he's betrothed, I advise that you do the right thing. I mean, you should take charge. You know what's up. You move in. He is a complete gentleman. I mean, proper one. He's not. There's no way he will chase you out. Just do the right thing. Go get your things. Move in. I mean, that's your man we're talking about here. We do not need to teach you how to do it. All right? We are here to support you.
No, I feel the prince is to ask me to move in.
Melody.
My queen.
Do you really want my son?
Yes. I love him so much, so I would love to spend time with him.
Then go home.
Do as we said.
Get your things. Come back and move in with him.
Yes.
Before another woman does.
Right?
Go. What is right? Go. She start making move right
now. Oh, baby, you're back. Welcome.
Melody.
Yeah, baby.
What are you doing here?
Okay, baby. You know, on my way out, your mom spoke to me. So she made me see reasons, so I have to move in. So here is my luggage. I've moved in already.
You moved in?
Yeah.
You mean you've left your parents' place already and you moved in here?
Of course. My parents, they are aware of it and they're cool with it.
Your parents are cool with it?
Yeah, they're cool with it.
Wow, that's... sounds strange. I mean, what kind of parents would be cool with their daughter moving in with a man who's not married to her yet? It's quite sudden.
Oh, baby. Your mom made them see reasons with the whole idea, and they're fine with it. So, baby, you know, your mom made me understand how lonely you've been all this while. I've been the only one on your mind. You hardly even get a woman. So now, I am here to fix it. Sweetheart, tell me what you want to have for lunch. I will go fix it for you. I don't need any servant to help me.
Excuse me.
Baby! Oh my God. Ah, this place. Can't wait to be spending a lot of time with my baby.
Listen, Melody, I don't know what my mother told you that made you bring yourself so low, despite your educational background, to moving with a man who's not married to you, but it's wrong. You're not my wife, you can't stay here.
Right?
Yeah, you have to move out.
Yeah, you're right. You know, when the queen suggested that I move in with you, I wasn't so comfortable with that. But I just have to obey her as the queen, you know, to move in here. But now you've said it, it's fine. I will move out.
You will?
Yes, I will. You know, my love, I love you so, so much. But I wouldn't want to be desperate about it. No. So anytime I make you so uncomfortable, please just let me know. I will retrace my steps, okay? Because I only want to be loyal to you and submissive as your woman.
As my woman?
Yes, baby.
Melody, what is wrong with you? First of all, thank you for your understanding. I appreciate it. Secondly, you're not my woman, okay? At least not yet. I'm sorry if my stand offends you, but that's my kind of person. I love to do things the right way. And honestly, I don't know why I have the kind of mother I have. I mean, how can she advise that you move in with a man who's not married to you? It's wrong. You're not my wife yet, so let's do things the right way, okay?
It's all right, I understand. I'm just very happy that I will get to see your face every day. You know, I can't wait for you to ascend the throne as the king and I, Melody, as your queen. Because I know that you're going to be a blessing to all your subjects.
Melody.
Yeah?
What is going on here?
As you can see, I'm back to where I belong.
Meaning?
You know, my prince, your brother, spoke to me. I saw reasons in what he was saying. I'm not supposed to be in his room. I'm supposed to be here. So, here I am, back to where I belong. Truly belong. So, baby girl, I'll be sharing your room with you.
Well, Melody, you're joking, right? No, you can't be serious. You can't possibly be serious.
Wait a minute. Are you that dumb that you let him brainwash you like that?
No.
Go back to his room. That's where you belong, not here.
So, meaning you're asking me to leave your room?
Mother, can you imagine your son, brother Kanai? Sending his bride to be to come and stay with me instead of keeping her in his own room. Like, who does that?
It's very simple. If you love her so much, you want her to be in our house, she can stay in your room.
Hey, God Almighty. Like, I believe you are man enough. This is time for you to prove it. Prove to us that you are truly man enough. By letting her stay with you. Melody is a pretty girl and she's classy, like every man's dream girl, yeah? She should be in your room. All those classless, dirty, smelly. I don't even know what to describe them because they are inconsequential as far as I am concerned. Man up! The point is for you to do the right thing. I need not to teach you all this. You are a big boy, you know what to do. I mean, a crown prince, royalty.
Mother, I see you called for this meeting for this little girl to insult me.
That's not true. How can I call a meeting for your kid sister to insult you? All I'm saying is for you to take that girl in. Apologize to her for chasing her out.
Simple.
She is your betrothed.
Yes.
So why would you chase her out of your room? It's not fair.
Well, I'm sorry to disappoint you, Mother. I will not do that. No, I won't.
Yes, I had a discussion with Melody and she understood why such a thing would be done. She knows this is the right thing. We're not yet married, so she can't be in my room. She understood it. She said she was going to leave and she left.
Melody said that? Surprisingly, she did.
What?
And I'm still trying to wrap my head around why she would accept that or agree to such. Because it's crazy. Is she that careless? But why would she let him brainwash her like that?
I'll tell you why. That's because Melody has brains. Unlike my younger sister here, who speaks and acts without thinking.
This life is full of us. No one is too little to be ignored. And you need never.
Greetings, my queen.
Greetings, my queen. My queen, if you see the fish I bought for you, it's very big. It's bigger than the money you gave me. Immediately, the seller saw me, said, I like her. She now gave me very big fish.
This is when you're coming back from the errand I sent you since morning. Eh?
My queen, please. Just take it easy on her.
You don't know this girl. She is the major problem I'm having in this palace. How can I send this big for nothing fool to go get me fish that is supposed to take 30 minutes? She went there and spent an hour. Who does that?
Oh my God.
I'm sorry, my queen.
Are you talking on your...
Please, take it easy. You're being too harsh on her. I was here when you sent her to go get the fish. It's not even up to an hour. It's not even up to 20 minutes.
Melody, 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 please. Hold it right there. Don't say what you do not know. Don't.
Nana. When
I wait for me. My queen, please, calm down.
When I wait for
what did you just do? No, I just let her have this little taste of my kindness for serving me cold meal this morning. Evil girl.
Come on.
Evil child.
That was so intense. Yes.
What if something has happened to her from the cake? What if something happens to her stomach?
Do I look like I care? Do I? It will gladden my heart if she dies. Yes!
Sorry. What has she done to you?
Did you not hear me say she served me cold meal this morning? Did you?
Cold meal? But I had the same meal with you. Yes. Okay, fine. It wasn't that hot. But it wasn't cold. It was just, you know, warm. Is that why you have to kick her?
Well, Melody, listen, I do not know about you and I don't even care to know, all right? As far as I'm concerned, the meal this cursed child served me this morning was as cold as ice block. Now look at me, look at me, I'm talking to you. The next time, I will give you a hot slap that will make you go deaf completely. I promise you that.
Oh, Osinachi, what happened to you? What happened? What changed you? Come on, why are you this inhuman? A princess should be seen as such. A princess is someone who is supposed to be caring for her people. And not the other way around. Do you want to kill her?
The goal is to get rid of her completely. Yes, this girl is nothing but a cursed child. A complete slave. That her corpse belongs to nothing but the evil forest. And I pray that when she dies, she goes straight to hellfire so she doesn't have any reason whatsoever to come to our land again.
Oh my God.
Now get up.
Sorry, ma.
Get up. Sorry. Run to your room. And as for you, I'm just going to take it lightly with you because you are my friend. I won't have to warn you again. When next you see me dealing with this slave girl, do not interfere. Please.
Oh my God.
Ihoma, hold on, please.
Take care. Hello.
Greetings, ma.
Why are you limping?
Please, I'm not the person in charge of your food. Chidima is, and I'm sure she must be setting the table for you.
Please. Come here, come here.
Ma, please.
Oh, sorry, does my body hurt?
No, ma, but...
So why can't you attend to me?
I'm a cursed slave for life. And I was warned never to come close to you. Please, let me go. I don't want to lose my job.
Lose your job? No, don't say that. Come on. We are all human. We have blood flowing through our vein. So there should not be any disparity. That is so wrong. I've been noticing the way they maltreat you in this palace since I stepped in here. I don't like it. Why are they treating you like that? Please, I'm so, so sorry, okay?
Please don't say sorry. Ma, please. I beg you in the name of God. Nobody says sorry to me in this palace. Only the prince does that. And if anyone hears you now, they will say that I've used charm or witchcraft on you. And it will be a big problem for me, Biko.
Charm? In this modern age? Please, stop it. Nobody will ever say that. I don't want you to be scared of anything. Just be yourself and believe in yourself, okay?
Thank you, ma'am. Thank you. God bless you, ma'am.
Should I help you?
No, ma'am. God bless you.
Are you sure you're fine?
Yes, ma'am.
Oh, my God. Please, take it easy. Life.
I can see you much better now. So how do you feel today?
I feel better, my prince.
Sure?
Yes, my prince. All right.
What about the walking now? Is it improving?
Yes, my prince. Thank you so much.
I see. All right. Anything you need, let me know.
Thank you, my prince.
Greetings. How are you?
Easy.
Thank you, my prince.
Melody.
Hi, baby.
How are you?
I'm good. I can see you're getting along with the workers. Especially that girl, Ihoma.
The one that just left here.
Yes, the one that is limping. I mean, that's so good. You're not like your sister and your mom.
How do you mean?
Well, they're so terrible. I've seen the way they maltreat those palace workers. I don't know why.
Believe me, you've not seen anything yet. If you see real wickedness from those two people, you'll be asking yourself, where did these people come out from? Honestly, are they human beings? They're so heartless.
Oh. You know, I've witnessed like two or three. You need to see the way they unleash their wickedness on those girls. Especially the slave girl.
They want to kill her. How don't you understand? I keep asking myself, how did I get to have a mother and a sister who behave like this? I don't get it.
I hope the Igwe is not like them.
No. My father is different. It's just that most times my father is indecisive. Yes, he says one thing right now, the next minute he's saying something else. You know, especially when it comes to matters of the palace, you know, matters that concern our people. He says no, the next time he's saying yes. I find it difficult to understand, but me, I love to be decisive, you know. I love to handle issues. That's why I'm championing the cause of equality. I'm championing the cause of abolishing this Osu caste system in our place. Yeah.
You mean they still practice down here?
Yes. Yes, unfortunately.
Wow.
It's terrible.
Oh, that's crazy.
It is.
So what's good? Baby, you know what? You were right. Yes. You know, your mom made her way into my head. I didn't even know what I was thinking. You know, she made me believe you were having an affair with that girl, Ihoma. That's so bad of me. What am I supposed to question your character? Come on. You're Prince Kanayo, a perfect gentleman. So I shouldn't question your character in any way. Please forgive me, baby. It will never happen again.
It's all right. It's all right, I forgive you. It's okay. See, Ihoma is a girl I'm just helping, you know. She's going through a lot. Bahola. Of all the maids in this palace, she is the hardest worker. Yet she's the least paid. All because they see her as an osu, an outcast, you know. And I just hate it. It annoys me, so I'm just trying to protect her and save her from danger. That's it.
You're right. Keep doing more. Help her. Yes, it's good to help another human. I'm so sorry for my assumption. It will never happen again, okay? Just give me a smile. That's my baby.